In the Canary Islands, hopes are high. We may not be clear of the winter storm just yet, but here, the sunny weather prevails. On top of that, people are still out and about, enjoying the freedom, and once again, feeling totally at home in Fuerteventura. Last time, we began following the story of Andrea and Gavin, who were looking to buy a holiday home in Fuerteventura. With the help of Alex from Goldacre Estates, they've drawn up a short list of properties, and we'll be joining them for the ride as they investigate each one. Also, we'll be reporting from our first ever HomeInFuerteventura.tv live event, with special guests Baycrest Wealth. And we'll be going off the beaten track on the East Coast in search of a notoriously elusive lagoon. Meanwhile, in Coralejo, it's November, and the ever-popular annual kite festival returns, drawing families together from all over Europe. Helping to represent British kite flyers in this multinational spectacular is Dick Abbs of KiteWeekenders.com.
Great to be chatting with you here at such a spectacular event, a regular event that happens here on Fuerteventura. How long have you been participating in flying these spectacular kites?
17 years. This is one of the events we go to from Britain. It's certainly my favourite event.
Are these optimal conditions for flying a kite today?
Today, now, is absolutely perfect. Yeah. It's about 12, 13 miles an hour now. That's lovely.
What's your schedule like?
We've normally all met up in the Chinese restaurant in the High Street on the Saturday night prior to the kite festival. This year, there's about 10 from the UK here, about 40 from Germany. We've got a small contingent from Finland as well.
Oh,
half
great,
a dozen this year. Normally, we're about 130 strong.
How many kites do you personally own?
I just bring a suitcase full of kites, and I make kites specifically to fit in a suitcase. But I suppose I've got well over 100 kites, and I've made them all.
Where do all these kites come from? Do people make them all?
There's a huge mixture. Lots and lots and lots of the kites you see here are originals, homemade. They're all around certain basic principles. Stick kites are, anyway. Inflatable kites, most of them do not fly at all. They are simply hoisted on a line by a lifter kite that does fly.
So yours is kind of more true.
Mine fly.
So the days of tying a handkerchief on the tail of a kite, that's not completely
still
done
work.
With.
Still works. Still works perfectly, and they are super fun, and you can pick up things out of the rubbish bin and make a good flying kite. What the festival means to me, and certainly I think for just about every one of the Brits and the Germans and the other people who come here, is the camaraderie and coming here, the warmth, the sun. We're just a loose group of friends that meet at different festivals and get together.
We're here on the Friday talking to you when they bring the schools here, the kids, and you've got the kids.
This is particularly good here at this beach because the kids all fly the kites down the bottom near the sea. But when we fly for the first day at the festival, El Cotillo, they fly in amongst us, and we spend all day in fits of laughter. The local authority provides kites for all the kids, which this year I've never seen so many. So if you go down there, it looks like a mass of knitting in the sky.
You plan to come back next year?
Absolutely. Look to book just after Christmas and then get on with the kiting season in the UK, and when it draws to a close, think, well, not long to Fuerte.
Dick, it's been an absolute pleasure having this conversation. Lovely to have a conversation about the kite festival here, and someone kind of on the inside as well. So really appreciate you talking to
all
us today.
All the best to you.
Yeah, and all the best to you too.
With their hopes flying high for finding a family holiday home in Fuerteventura, Andrea and Gavin arrive at their first viewing in Antigua Bay, a residential community in Costa de Antigua.
Not a bad view, no. Not at all. Yeah, it's lovely.
And what the owner did is put a new kitchen in there. The only thing you have to add in there is an oven. Decent sized kitchen space for the property.
You know. Yeah. I like this little mini bar area here too.
It'd be fine for our family. For visitors, maybe not so much.
The key thing is, when you're trying to find space for me, it's about lifting everything off the floor.
Putting the television up on the wall kind of thing.
And then, of course, just out here, that's where you've got your balcony. I mean, you can feel the breeze coming all the way through as well.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it's lovely. Nice. Yeah, that's actually lovely too. Yeah. Nice view over there too, in the evening.
Get on well with the curry house, they can just pass stuff upstairs, you see.
Get one of those dumbwaiter things.
Exactly, exactly. But even from here, you know, just looking down the road there, you've got a little bit more of the sea down there as well. And again, you know, in front of us, these have been, you know, kind of recently sold, you know, over time. If you did have a car, you know, you can just put it in space and go from there. And because it's a corner, you've actually got the benefit of window in the lounge. Yeah. And window in the bathroom as well. Upstairs, we have the two bedrooms and the bathroom. We'll start with the main bedroom here and the triple wardrobes as well, you know, so it's got plenty of space there.
Yeah, it's perfect. Yeah. It is kind of it's a good sized bedroom here. Yeah,
bathroom there.
Okay, yeah.
Right. It's actually been refurbed. Like I said, you know, it's nice to have that window. You might want to frost the glass while you're in the shower.
Waving out to people, but yeah, a bit of frosted.
You get to know your neighbours, you know.
They get to know us a little too well, though.
Yeah, decent bathroom, okay. And then
that's the more single room that I was talking about, you know, so that, you know, again, maybe from the kids' point of view, you have bunk beds in there, you know.
Yeah, you could get bunk beds easily in there. Oh, no, they're good-sized bedrooms.
Yeah, they're really nice.
Yeah, I like them.
We've got the community fees on here are €54 a month. So again, quite reasonable considering you've got the pool and everything like that, which we'll go have a look at in a minute. Yeah, I mean, it's clean, it's tidy, you know. You can squeeze a double in there, probably a 135 rather than a 150. 105,000, you know.
Very, very good price. Yeah. Perfect for our family.
Yeah.
Like that, it's just, do I want another room? Am I willing to sacrifice that third bedroom for the price? It's something to consider anyway.
Exactly, exactly. Yeah. Shall we have a look at the communal areas?
Yes.
Yeah, all right.
We'd spend most of the time outside anyway, exactly. Down by the pool and enjoying the sun.
And I like that we could sit on our balcony here. I love that it has the gates, the gated area. It's so completely safe.
And the main pool is all fenced as well.
Yeah, so you're only really having the residents around here too.
Exactly.
Gorgeous pool. Really nice pool.
It is really nice.
And then kind of walking a little bit further up that way. Again, I'll just show you kind of literally just past this line of properties here. You've just got some open kind of planted areas and everything like that, which is nice.
Yeah, it's very clean.
Yeah.
It's a nice, I'm impressed, I am.
And again, it's nice and quiet as well. I mean, there is a mix here. You know, you have got a lot of residents full time on here. You've got holiday homes as well. All over there, you know, super clean, super tidy. You know, it's all irrigated.
That's all part of your fees would be. So as well, what, like, what's 54?
54 a month.
Which, can look at the job they're doing. It's good value for money.
Is money well spent?
No, I do. I really like it. It's definitely something to think about.
It's got the two bedrooms. Obviously, three would be great, you know. But yeah, I think for where we are as well in Costa Antigua, you know, you have got the bits around you.
It's not too far from Coleta either, yeah. The position of the property is a good good position compared to, like, it's nice to be there rather than around the corner there.
Exactly.
Yeah, because you're looking right onto the pool.
And you have your beach views as well. You couldn't get a better position.
Making a home in Fuerteventura is an adventure with exciting twists and turns. And planning for the times ahead is a great way to see how your relationship with Fuerteventura might evolve. Helping to guide us through our financial future on Fuerteventura are Hayley, Cliff and Ian from Baycrest Wealth, who recently spoke at our first ever live event held in Caleta de Fusta.
Thank you very much for coming along. It's lovely to see you here on this Monday morning. We're here to help you. We're not here to try and sell things to you, because I'm sure a lot of you have got lots of questions. You've got things that you're not quite sure about now that you're living out of the UK. And we're here to share our expertise. We have over 20 years experience in the international market. This is my colleague Cliff. He's an international financial advisor, and also my colleague Ian. And we pride ourselves in being specialists in the Spanish market and understanding the complexities of the Spanish system. So essentially, we're going to talk to you a little bit about if you have anything still in the UK in terms of assets, what's the best position for you to be in if you do still hold these assets. And also, a big one for us is we're highly specialised in pensions, and particularly if you have a UK pension, and it's understanding what's the best thing to do with that pension so that it works best for you now that you're a resident over here. We didn't want to just talk at you, so we were quite keen to know if there was anything you were particularly interested in.
We've got clients out here on the island, and we were introduced to Steve and told about what he was doing with Home and Fuerteventura TV. And I think it's very clear to see his passion both for the island as well as for what he's doing with the program. And that passion kind of resonated with us because we really quite enjoy what we do. And the only way that you really survive in our industry is by having a decent reputation. From Corporate Livewire was the Spain Prestige Awards, and we just got notified last week that we've won Financial Advisor of the Year.
And even though it's us three that are front-facing, this isn't just the team. We've got 15, 20 people behind us doing the governance, doing the compliance, checking the licenses, checking the work. So it's really, really regulated. I think this is a very personable business. But that's not to say you can't deal with us whilst we're on the mainland. If it requires, we jump on a plane. We're 2 hours away. But we've got licenses around the world allowing us to deal with clients globally. This is your money. You worked hard for it. Let someone else look after it and you go and enjoy your lives. Don't be stuck in front of the screen thinking, I wonder if Apple's going to go up today, or Facebook's going to go down, or what's all this about Bitcoin? Hot topic. Everyone talks about crypto.
The problem with crypto is that some of them make phenomenal gains and some of them absolutely disappear. There's nothing wrong with having a little punt on cryptos. You know, I'm not against cryptos by any means, but don't put your life savings into it where if it goes wrong, you know, it has a serious impact on your standard of living. By way of financial planning at the stage that we're at the moment, it's not something we go near. And actually a lot of the institutions that we deal with, and we're talking huge, robust global institutions, are still not willing to accept any crypto-based assets because of the risks involved.
I know you're desperate for teas and coffees and a bit of refreshments. I've spotted some muffins on the bar as well. Thank you very much for your time and your interest.
It was great to meet so many of you at our first live event, and we appreciate the feedback you gave us. Do keep the comments coming. Your suggestions and support really do help. Also helping to make Home in Fuerteventura.tv possible are all our kind sponsors who are backing Fuerteventura's future. Among them are Woodside Cargo, who connect Fuerteventura with the world through their shipping and pet relocation services. Woodside Cargo have been moving lives and businesses on and off the island since 2003, taking great care of people's possessions and the paperwork for transporting them. James, Annette and the team are thorough and thoughtful, looking after your possessions and pets on their long journey across the continent. For moving your life on or off Fuerteventura, you can rely on Woodside Cargo. We're staying in the Antigua municipality to go off the beaten track. However, this favourite of mine technically is beaten every day, not by feet or wheels, but by waves. To get the best out of this track, timing is everything, with the real treasure only revealed at low tide.
It never ceases to amaze me how beautiful this place is, especially this time in the afternoon where it's just coming on for sunset. The tide is just coming in, so it's perfect for swimming here in the lagoon in Caleta de Fusta. If you're nimble enough to make the climb, it's certainly well worth doing. Obviously, check out the tides. Make sure you come at low tide. This really has to be the ultimate ocean view swimming pool here. The rocks are nice and warm where they've had the sun on them all day. It's a nice place to be. You definitely need shoes to be able to make the climb down, and you've got to watch the barnacles, watch the slippery bits as well. Just tread carefully and you'll be absolutely fine. There are plenty of fish to share the pool with. It's a fun little expedition. The birds are tame here. They're very cute. Beautiful spot. Anyway, the lagoon's starting to flood now, so I think it's best time to pack up and move on. I've got to rescue my shoes now.
Time to head north and see how Andrea and Gavin are getting on with Alex from Goldacre Estates as he shows them around some property opportunities at Mirador de las Dunas in Coralejo. A batch of bank repossessions have become available in the area, and while they could be bargains, they could also be in need of significant work.
Obviously, we are going to have a look at a few of these. Yeah, we'll start with the last ground floor one left. You're going to be looking at new kitchen, obviously furniture. They're actually retiling all of here, which is nice, because last time I came up here, there was a few broken tiles and everything like that, so they're actually community retiling. And the pool from here is not far away either. What's nice about these is you've only got actually one neighbour, in effect, because then the other neighbours are in the next block along. The size of the apartments are really, really good, you know? This is one of the ones that needs more work done to it.
Oh, wow. Oh, this is a nice big area.
So, of course, in comparison to Antigua Bay, you're getting a lot more internal space here. Three bedrooms, obviously, with these, yeah. First bedroom there. So you've got your ensuite there as well, which is nice. Built-in wardrobes, or what's left of them.
It's a lot of work to this.
This is 135,000. When you start to see the next lot that we're going to as well, you're really going to start to weigh up and say, really, for the extra, you know what I mean? So we've got two of the mid-floors to have a look at here. We've actually got one that's facing out towards the sea, which is really nice. With the sea view one, obviously, you just keep in mind about the empty plot of land in front of you. You will be looking onto building for sure. Just depends how high that building will go, to whether you keep the view or not. All right, so here we are. Kitchen is actually almost perfect. Yeah? And of course, I mean, what some people do, which I didn't mention in the other apartment, is they do knock down this wall. If you want more open plan, you can knock down that wall if you want to. Utility room just there.
Well, that's handy.
Nice little storage room, yeah.
And then you've got bathroom there as well. So still a few bits to do in this. Not as much as the last one, you know, so we're upgrading bit by bit. So first bedroom, absolutely identical size as the previous apartment as well. And again, it's nice the amount of light that comes through as well, isn't it?
Yeah, it's lovely.
Yeah. I love the size.
Finally, main bedroom with ensuite as well. So you see what I mean with bank repossessions? They are hit and miss, you know? It's kind of, that's why you've got to look at all the units, really, to be honest with you, you know, because they do change massively from one to the other.
Yeah, it's a nice little view there too, yeah. Until something builds up there.
That's the thing, you know, and so the permissions for that part of the plot in front of us were for another block of apartments. That was what the permission's for. Now, whoever buys that, whether they're gonna do that, whether they're gonna change it up or not, we just don't know. And then straight through there, obviously back through to the lounge area as well.
And I like how it's nice and open here with all the windows here, and there's a lovely view of the sea there.
Yeah.
It's really nice.
So, you know, looking down to Lobos Lanzarote, you know, and again, like we said, less work to do to this one. This is 125,500, and then the next one we're going to have a look at, because it doesn't have the sea view, is 123,350, I think. How does it compare to the downstairs one? I mean, not just the work, but in terms of not having the outside space?
That's the only thing that's missing. Yeah. The only thing that's missing.
But I mean, actually, because the mid-floor was always, I didn't really want that. I wanted the outside area, but it's kind of almost an outside area over here. Exactly. And like the windows are open pretty wide, like they open out pretty far there. So it is, again, that extra space over there. Although it's doing nothing, there is kind of potential to do something there, yeah.
This is the next one, which of course we're facing the other way, but you know, again, another way to think about that is that you've secured what's in front of you. Nothing's going to change, you know what it is, and that's it. Kitchen just through there, clean and tidy. And you can see, I mean, absolute identical layout.
Very good.
But it is a nice big utility room, isn't it? So
yeah,
it is. Fit in there, yeah.
I like your bathroom, perfect.
It's brighter here too. No, painting. You're going to do that anyway, you're going to do painting anyway, no matter what.
And then again, master there. Somebody's left you some decorations there. You've got a couple of stickers on the wall.
You literally just need your furniture.
What's nice is that the downstairs neighbours have actually got some nice greenery, you know, so it's kind of growing up. That's quite nice. And one thing that I did notice going into there, if you look straight down the road, so over the pool to your left-hand side, you actually get a view of the sea and the dunes, so there you go. So that's the other mid-floor, and price point of this one is almost $5,000 cheaper than the last one.
It's not worth $5,000, the view isn't.
You just get a nice comfy chair sat here, and you just kind of like point it that way, and you're good to go, you know?
Beautiful sea views.
Exactly. We've got the pool area just here.
Oh, it's gorgeous.
So nice area, you know. You know, you've got facilities on site as well.
Yeah. Definitely somewhere I could see.
All the kids.
Yeah.
Really, really nice pool. I love the bridge area.
You just want to dive in there now, don't you? I'm like, just like, I'm roasting.
I'd love a swim right now. It's gorgeous.
It's beautiful, isn't it? It's a really gorgeous area.
I love the pool area.
This is what you're paying the community fees for here, you know, approximately 75 a month.
I love this area. But we would spend most of the day, down, especially with the kids, down by the pool, sitting around, maybe a couple of cocktails. We'd make them ourselves, bring them down. Good swim with the kids, and then during the evening time, we'd go out.
Andrea and Gavin are obviously enamoured with the pool area, but don't seem overly excited about any of the bank repossession apartments. However, Alex has one final property in the area to show them. Going over budget, it's a wild card. So let's return to Mirador de las Dunas shortly to see if Andrea and Gavin are game. Back down in Caleta de Fusta, Hayley, Ian and Cliff are catching their breath after a busy day by soaking in the setting sun at Playa La Guerra.
What kinds of people are you working with?
Across the board. So we're working with people who are still professionals, who are still working. We work with a lot of pilots, work with all different nationalities. We also work with people who have retired many years ago, are still looking to make financial plans for the future. So it really is diverse.
To actually be interested in financial planning, it's not like you actually need to have a load of capital.
The myth with financial planning is it's a bit boring, and not many people want to sit down and actually think about, oh gosh, I need to set some time apart. I'll put it on the back burner. A lot of people put it off. They also think, well, actually, I need to have a lot of money. And it's not true. Actually, the whole point is that it's about planning for your future. Start looking at your situation now and where you want to be, and just have a conversation. So it's very easy to do. We welcome anyone just having that initial conversation to see whether we can help or whether we can't help, or whether actually what you've got in place now is ideal for you.
It's a long-term relationship. You know, we're talking years.
We're here in your interest, and actually the longer the relationship we have, the better, the more we understand your situation, the more we can help you.
People think that you need to have this chunk of money, mm-hmm. and that you want to invest in something to get the return on that money, and that's what financial advice is. But actually, when you look at financial planning, people reach different stages in life and require different plans for different stages of life. You can really make a substantial difference to your standard of life or your quality of life by thinking a little bit earlier. But in the 20s, you might be able to put a little bit aside, and then you might end up with a family. Well, now you've also got to start thinking about education fees. And so there's another little track to go on. And it might be that you've got several plans on the go at the same time, but you're creating a bigger picture to be able to get as close as you can to these things. You might not hit every single one of them, which is why we always say, you know, the journey is more important than the destination, because the destination is always changing. Yeah. You know, you never get to that point and you go, that's me, done.
What I think the misconception might be with financial advisors is that you sit down with a financial advisor and the minute you start talking to them, the meter's running.
And that's not what we're about.
It's a misconception this is only for the super rich.
Yeah.
It's not.
And just talk to us.
There's also a misconception that as soon as you sit down, you're going to be charged. It's not. You only get charged the fee that we charge you when you take our advice. And you may choose not to.
Yeah.
It's that simple. It's helping people reach their objectives with our help.
Yeah, you know, to see people achieving goals and ambitions or objectives that they've had that you've managed to play a little part in makes it more worthwhile.
I really enjoy working for the company. I love where the office is. I love the work we do, how we can help people, and I also kind of love where we live in Spain. I think it's just a beautiful place to be. It's living the dream.
Yeah, totally.
Very rewarding as well.
I love the fact that we can work with people all over the world from such a beautiful part of the world.
So what's next for Baycrest Wealth? Why the Canary Islands?
Baycrest Wealth are really keen to get out to the Canaries to extend the service and the advice that we provide so that the people here are not left out, you know, because they do want to live the dream. And you don't want to come out to live the dream, fall into a trap that costs you so badly that your dream's shattered and you're no longer able to do it, you know. So we want to play a little part in being able to make sure that we can help people along the way to continue with that path.
What's your experience of the Canary Islands?
Yeah, we're loving it. A really, really special place. I mean, where we are right now, what an amazing view.
Yeah, we've got the whole place to ourselves as well. We frightened everyone off.
Yeah. we're going to come here. We're going to have a little swim in this lagoon tomorrow.
Yeah?
Yeah, really experience it.
We've done quite a few sporting competitions, so we've done quite a bit of training here. It's very, very rugged and beautiful for swimming, running, cycling, and Yeah, it's a joy every time we get to come back here.
The sun's setting, it's been a great day. I think it's time to go and grab some food. What do you think?
Sounds awesome.
Absolutely. Let's do it.
Meanwhile, the clock up in Coralecco is ticking. Alex has found what might be the best of the bank repossessions, but will it woo Andrea and Gavin?
So this is actually, square meterage-wise, it's exact same as the apartments, but it's just split over a couple of levels. Out here, this is your garden, back garden. So here you haven't got any problems whatsoever in raising the walls. If you want to raise the walls in block, you can do. If you want to raise the walls in wood, fencing, whatever you want.
Yeah, probably just a bit of fencing around here. Yeah.
Morning sun on this side, afternoon sun on the front side.
If there was no trees.
If there's no trees, exactly. Once you've trimmed it back, you know. But of course, on the roof terrace, it's like all day long.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's good to go now, I like it. Yeah. Right. A lot of potential there for doing something with this out here. Yeah.
Exactly. I mean, I've seen a few of these, you know, I mean, some people have put jacuzzis in the back here as well. Kitchen is, I have to say, in really, really cool condition. You know, you probably wouldn't even change this, to be fair.
No, you wouldn't.
You know? So you've just saved cost-wise. I mean, even if you've got an IKEA kitchen, what are you talking, $3,000? Something like that, you've just saved the better part of that. Okay, we still need fridge, freezer, and dishwasher, if you want, yeah?
Yeah, pretty small fridge to fit in there.
Well, it's not too bad.
They would have had to leave standard size.
It is, yeah. You can get a fridge in there. Okay. So, three bedrooms, just like the apartments. Two of the same size, plus main bedroom and ensuite.
The condition is fantastic, isn't it?
Yeah.
And what's nice is that you're slightly elevated above the line in front of you. So you'll notice that more when we get to the roof terrace. Next bedroom on the left-hand side is, again, pretty much a mirror image.
I love this. I love the balcony, yeah. It's nice.
Perfect.
A nice big room as well.
Even the ensuite is perfect. The shower, everything. Everything is done to it.
When it's rained, you can see just the running water coming down. You just get it resealed. A lot of people have replaced it, to be honest with you. A lot of people have replaced it. They've taken off the plastic and put like a glass there, yeah? Because there's not a lot of damp in this, I would, rather than spending the money to replace it straight away, I would try and seal it first. Because
yeah.
That's a nice, cheap and cheerful option.
Yeah.
And if you see that works, perfect. Just get that repainted, you know, and that's it, job done. I mean, you might, obviously, to make that, you either restain that, you know, just strip it back a little bit, re-varnish it, you know, and go from there. Or just replace the door frame.
Yeah.
Finally, to the roof terrace. You finally get a roof terrace here, you see.
Yeah, it's what we've been waiting for all day.
It's gorgeous.
Yeah. Panoramic, really, isn't it?
And that view will never change.
Lovely.
Rooftop terrace with sea views.
Yeah. Stunning. You would, like, for the extra few quid, you wouldn't go with the apartment.
For me, it's the best one in terms of condition-wise I've seen.
It's in great condition.
In a while.
What's this?
Boiler.
Hooked up? Not hooked up, we had to replace.
Yeah, I mean, you'd get rid of this one. You'd get rid of this one, but it's all hooked up, but you just get a new one.
New boiler.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to cost you, for that size, €120.
Oh, really?
I think the boiler itself, and then if you pay somebody to actually put it in there, I guess somebody will charge you a couple hundred euros to do all the job and everything.
We got our boiler replaced this year, €2,500. Fantastic. Love it. This is kind of what I've been picturing and imagining.
Yeah.
All the family up here, barbecues, there's a bit of furniture up here. A lot of space as well. Lots of space.
Andrea and Gavin are deep in thought. Although it's over budget, this villa appears to be their favourite. But do they love it enough to put down the €3,000 deposit? It's back to the Goldacre Estates office for some serious decision making.
We want somewhere where we can have, obviously for our family to enjoy when we're not there also.
Yeah.
If they want to go away for a week or two.
It's a home that's going to see a lot of love, isn't it, really? Absolutely. From that point of view, because it's not a house that's going to sit there for months and months dormant, not doing anything.
I don't think there's anything else out there for the kind of space that you get there.
No,
for that budget.
And you're still pretty close to Coralecco, that's the other thing. But what do you think you're going to do?
I think we're going to end up going for
Really?
The townhouse, yeah.
Yeah. Can we read it out again with us saying that we're not going to go for it, just in case it doesn't work out? You can use both shots.
Yeah. Have you told the kids?
They know that we're out here looking at properties. Well,
they're going to be really excited.
They love the idea of having their own home away on holidays. Yeah. Like, they love holidays just as much as we do.
At 150, you've got a house you can pretty much move into. Yeah. Yes. I mean, that's what would excite me as a person who's a bit rubbish at DIY. Yeah. I'm not saying that you are, but you know,
I'm handy enough. I'm thinking more of my
He's lazy house. Though.
I'm lazy.
He can do it. I have to ask him 5-10 times before he'll actually do it.
You just don't need to remind me every 6 months.
He used to be an electrician. It takes me...
Oh, you've got no excuse then?
Yeah. It could take me weeks to get him to change a switch.
Oh my God, are you still going on about that switch?
Oh my God, the switch. It took about 3 months to get a switch changed.
I had to move the bed and everything to do it.
The thing is, if it's not bothering you, then...
It was bothering me though.
Yeah. Just couldn't plug the dryer in. So I just got an extension lid.
You've almost got a solid plan here because you kind of got this one.
Yeah. If it's not gone...
If it's not gone.
They seem to get snapped up quickly.
I know. So. Oh, Alex, do they just go?
They just go.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it's we have to check literally, a couple of times back.
Yeah.
To double check availability.
And that's why we need to kind of do that today to make sure it is still there.
We had that arranged behind. She went to the ones, when I went to the security guard, she was there for all of the winter as well.
Yeah, I think we should do that with number 43.
That's what I mean. It's like, yep. Don't hold your hopes too high on one particular unit.
Yeah.
You know, okay, that was really nice unit. But don't hold your hopes too high. This has happened so many times where we've been chatting and stuff.
And then it's gone.
Right. I'm not going to hold you up by chatting anymore. I'm going to say thank you very much.
Somebody else
in case, quick. So I'm going to say thank you so much for appearing on homingforwardventura.tv. It's been an absolute pleasure to meet both of you. Whatever happens with this, I do hope you find your dream home in Fuerteventura. And if you do, invite us around for a coffee.
Of course. Forget the coffee, a glass of wine.
Oh, yeah. Make it too. Lovely to meet both
you,
Andrea.
You too. Thank
and
you.
Gabs, thank you so much.
A hugely exciting decision has been made. Andrea and Gavin are going for their home in Fuerteventura. With no time to lose, we remove our mics to give everyone due privacy while reservations are made and details are exchanged. This part is just a formality. Nothing can stop them now. Or can it? Alex receives breaking news from the bank regarding number 43, Andrea and Gavin's chosen property. And it isn't good. Andrea and Gavin have been pipped at the post, and the family home they had their hearts set on is already sold. It's a crushing blow, but not a big surprise to Alex. Bank repossession prices are sometimes unbeatable, but that puts them in high demand with several simultaneous estate agents. As a result, many units do indeed just go, with no warning. Today, time has run out for Andrea and Gavin. However, our undeterred couple from County Kildare are keeping Alex on the case, and they will return to finish what they started. When they do, we'll be there. For so many of us, a home in Fuerteventura remains a dream. So together, let's keep dreaming.